It's 31 teams in 31 days. Matt Wehmeyer alongside Dan Rosen. Our focus today on the Montreal Canadiens capturing a third Atlantic Division crown in the last five seasons, despite a late season coaching change. Michel Therrien out, Claude Julien in. Julien taking over for the final 24 games of the year, but a disappointing first round playoff exit in six games at the hands of the Rangers. And Dan, that led to a slew of offseason changes.
Yes, a lot of changes for the Montreal Canadiens. Most notably, the biggest change I definitely think is the addition of Jonathan Drouin. We're talking about a guy who's 22 years old, acquired from the Tampa Bay Lightning for a very good defensive prospect in Mikhail Sergachev, but they needed offense, or they felt they needed offense, and they get it in Drouin. He had 21 goals and 53 points last season with the Lightning. That's in 73 games. He is on the verge of stardom, but again, now he's got to do it in his home province, one of the toughest media markets in the league, so it's going to be interesting to see how he handles it. But beyond that, defensively, Carl Alsner signed a five-year, $23.125 million contract with Montreal, played his entire career so far with the Washington Capitals. David Schlemko signed a four-year contract. Mark Streit returned to Montreal on a one-year deal. And even Joe Morrow, former Boston Bruin, signed a one-year contract. So a lot of changes on their D. And also Alex Hemsky signed a one-year deal. Lots and lots of changes, significant offseason changes for Montreal.
Now, on the flip side of that, Claude Julien regarded as one of the finest defensive minds in hockey, and he's going to have his work cut out for him because of some massive losses on that blue line.
Yes, so we talked about Alsner coming in and Schlemko and obviously Streit and Morrow, but look who they lost, and that's the key thing here. Andrei Markov, longtime Montreal Canadian, I think 990 games, 10 games shy of 1,000, all with Montreal. He's gone. He went to the KHL. At first, it looked like he wanted a two-year contract. They wouldn't give it to him. And then we heard he might have wanted just a one-year deal. Still didn't get it, so they've moved on for him. He and Shea Weber were a dynamic top pair for the Montreal Canadiens. They allowed 2 5-on-5 goals against when they were on the ice from February 28th through April 1st. Another big loss, Nathan Beaulieu. They traded him to the Buffalo Sabres. And also, Alexei Emelin got picked by the Vegas Golden Knights. And beyond that, there was another big loss up front. Alexander Radulov, let's not forget about him. 54 points last season in his first season back in the NHL. He was very good for the Habs. He went and signed a five-year contract with the Dallas Stars.
Even with Carey Price in net, the former Vezina Trophy winner, I think the biggest question for this team, as you just expounded upon, is the D going to be good enough?
Well, and that's the thing for them. This defense is not as good on paper as it was last season. When you take out Markov and you take out Beaulieu and Emelin, and you add in Alsner, Schlemko, and Streit, and maybe even Marl, you're taking away a lot of speed and a lot of offense. Yes, Carl Alsner is a good defensive defenseman, but he doesn't bring you the offense. Schlemko can be a power play guy, but he doesn't do a heck of a lot more. And Mark Streit was a scratch with the Pittsburgh Penguins in the playoffs last year. I don't know the kind of difference that he is going to make. He shouldn't be in the top six, and neither should Joe Morrow. So this defense is not good enough. The difference for the Montreal Canadiens, you brought him up at the top of this question, they have Carey Price, and everybody else does not, and that's the big difference.
Yeah, very much well said. And, Dan, I think these defensive issues could be crippling if they played in the Metro. They're in the Atlantic. Does that make them a playoff team?
It does. What makes them a playoff team, to me, is the fact that they have Carey Price. He punches their ticket to the playoffs. He's that good. He's an elite goaltender. He makes them a playoff team. What they do beyond that, I can't tell you because it's going to rely on a lot of other details and who they play. But, yes, they are a playoff team because of Carey Price.